and interesting patterns, and one of those is the crystal. A crystal is a pattern of atoms, and atoms are the fundamental building block of everything around us. And if you were to zoom in on the atoms in a crystal, you would see ordered rows and columns of atoms, and it's a pattern only succeeded in order and regularity by the marching women of the North Korean army. But what happens to this very very ordered pattern when you try to bend it or confine it to something curved like a sphere? In other words, what happens if we challenge the North Korean women to try march on something like a dome? It turns out that the curvature actually can destroy this perfect pattern. In other words, that the North Korean women will find themselves in a situation where they cannot keep up the same distance to the boots in front of them and to the sides. And to get a better understanding of how curvature affects this pattern, you can think of a standard soccer ball. A soccer ball is not completely white, it actually has these black patches. And they are different from the white ones because they have fewer edges. So if you were to pile something flat like a kitchen table, you would be perfectly fine with just the white ones. But if you want to wrap this pattern of patches up and make it fit around the sphere, then you need the black ones with fewer edges. It's a little bit the same with a crystal. Some of the atoms in the crystal have to be different than the other atoms in order to make the pattern of atoms fit around the sphere. So, curvature of something like a sphere can make the faults in this pattern, and I'm interested in understanding how crystals, this quite fundamental state of solid, fundamental